Terima kasih di atas kesetiaan anda bersama kami di 9-11. Seperti yang kita janjikan tadi, Fad, kan? Kita nak bawakan segmen inspirasi membawakan seorang individu.
Muda lagi?
Yang akan, ya, muda lagi. Itu yang saya...
Bagi saya sebenarnya.
Geramnya, kan? Kenapa tak sabar nak jadi macam dia sebenarnya? Sangat menginspirasikan individu di luar sana. Sebab kita bukan kata apa tau. Dia inspirasi daripada segi kerjaya. Dan sememangnya terkenal sebagai usahawan yang berjaya.
Betul.
Dalam sesama balance, orang kata ada juga kerja-kerja kebajikan yang dilakukan. Dan siapa tak kenal, The Tank Giving Bank, iaitu merupakan pelopor dan juga merupakan orang kata apa, idea beliau sendiri, di mana lahirnya The Tank Giving Bank.
Dan inilah individunya, seorang usahawan, seorang dermawan lagi, kan. Okey, kita dah, tak nak cakap banyak lagi, Nurul. Jom kita teruskan.
Kenalkan.
Sama warna tudung Nurul baju dia.
Betul, kita ada janji ke doktor?
Sama, kan? Okey, ingin kita kenalkan di sebelah ujung sana, Dr. Janson Ang Chiwi, Ketua Pegawai Eksekutif Janson Group. Dan untuk kata anda bahawa doktor ini menguruskan 4 kumpulan organisasi dan ada 29 anak syarikat di bawahnya.
Wow.
Macam bayangkan, kan?
Saya tak terbayang itu. Saya terdiam sekejap. Macam mana nak bekerja, nak bergerak?
Nak tahu juga apa rahsianya, resepinya sehingga boleh berjaya sampai sekarang ni, kan, Nurul?
Betul,
kan?
Jangan tanya saya.
Jom kita teruskan dengan doktor.
Mungkin doktor boleh kongsikan mengenai latar belakang doktor terlebih dahulu.
Yep. Myself, I'm actually into... I studied marketing back then in business. And I'm also... I have double major. I also did my engineering as well in US. After which, I come back and serve, you know, my family business lah, basically.
Okay, so katanya bermula di seawal umur 17 tahun lagi doktor dah melibatkan diri dalam bidang korporat. Mungkinkah waktu tu doktor dah terdedah dengan surrounding corporate world, ataupun doktor masuk-masuk je sememangnya inilah masanya saya kena belajar, dan bagaimana doktor nak adaptasikan diri tu, nak adapt diri tu untuk membiasakan dalam keadaan tersebut pada usia yang sangat muda, 17 tahun kita tengah
kata 5
uha-uha lagi
nak SPM masa tu.
I don't really have much inspiration, I would say, because I'm quite chartered. Even during my younger days, when we are in school, if you remember, teacher will always ask about our ambition, kan? Cita-cita, kan? What you want to be, you know, when you grow and things like that. So you have people coming up with saying, I want to be doctor, policeman and things like that. But ever since then, I have been very chartered. I wanted to anchor something on myself. So I've always been writing about business. I always wanted to be in business. I always want to have my own company, you know, and things like that. And how this thing came about is because of also some family struggles, you know, and things like that. And I've personally seen how my dad, I envy his life, lah, you know. He get to work on what he wants to work on. He has his own company, of course, a very small one, you know. And I see him as a businessman. I inspired, you know, I'm inspired in that sense. And I'm a person who like to travel around, fly around and things like that. So I've seen... You know, carrying briefcase, flying around and doing business is something fun and something uplifting to me. So this is how, you know, I started develop my interest in business.
Ya, betul apa yang doktor katakan tadi. Kalau kita sebenarnya ingin berjaya, kita harus struggle. Dan peluang yang diberikan tu kita kena guna sebaik mungkin.
Sebenarnya.
Dan saya nak tanya dengan doktor juga, dan mungkin penonton di luar sana tu pun dah terinspirasi dengan doktor. Mereka mungkin ada memulakan perniagaan. Mereka ingin menjadi usahawan yang berjaya seperti doktor, kan? Mungkin doktor boleh kongsikan apa mungkin kriteria yang mereka perlukan, ciri-ciri yang ada pada diri mereka untuk menjadi usahawan yang berjaya seperti doktor.
I think perseverance is very important. If you want to be in business, perseverance, determination, hard work, but of course, nevertheless, I always believe in what goes around comes around. When you reflect yourself in a mirror, when you smile, you know, you see someone smiling back at you. So it's a cycle, basically. It's an ecosystem where we have to adapt to good culture. Why I say culture is very important for a businessman is because when you do good to people, people will do good to you. You know, when you love someone, the person will love back to you. You see, so it's a cycle. You see, so I always believe in using this charisma. You know, to love everyone, to do good things. You know, and things like that, and automatically the things will start, you know, flowing back to you.
Saya suka dengar information doktor
Betul.
Ni. Dia menenangkan.
Menenangkan, dan salah satu lagi sebab apa awak boleh tenang, cara bercakap pun sambil bersenyum.
Seorang doktor Janson yang dikenali memang suka senyum. Senyum.
Murah rezeki. Orang cakap.
Macam awak lah, suka senyum juga.
Have to lah. Don't be stingy with your smile lah. When you smile at people, people will smile back at you. You know, it makes your day more positive. It creates better vibes, you know, and things like that. So you're more energized lah, basically, to fight forward and to move forward, basically.
Itu rasanya.
Kalau kita senyum dengan orang, orang tak senyum dengan kita balik, don't care.
Tak apa, continue
kan?
Senyum.
Senyum je, tak kisah kan. Yeah. Pedulilah apa
betul.
Kan.
Kita dah laksanakan diri kita, part kita dah selesai. Okey doktor, sekarang ni kita nak share juga ya. Kadang-kadang anak-anak muda ni kita lihat kan, mereka tak menggunakan peluang yang ada tu dengan sepenuhnya. Betul. Mereka lebih suka berhibur ataupun mereka mengatakan ini belum masanya untuk
muda
saya
lagi
bekerja keras. Ya, sebab muda lagi. Nantilah umur saya dah 30-an ke dan nak kahwin ke baru saya akan fikir untuk fokus pada kerjaya. Mungkin doktor boleh komen mengenainya.
I would say that kemahuan ada. They want. They know that they want. In fact, everyone knows that they want to be successful. They want to be rich. You know, they want to wake up having no stress in life and things like that. But they have to also understand that these are a certain process that they have to endure, you know. And the reason why they're not stepping out is because I could simply say that maybe because they are feeling complacent, too comfortable in their comfort zone. Maybe they feel they're not a risk taker. They just want to work from 8 to 5, you know, that sort of thing. And things like that. There's no wrong, no right to this sort of answer, you see. But of course, if you feel like you want to do something better, you know, and make a more impact in your life and things like that, certain risk portfolio mesti ada lah, you know. You have to endure sort, you know, sort movement before you can achieve greater results, you see. So this is basically what I feel, you know, that we should actually step up and fight for what we want, you see, rather than being in our comfort zone. You have to move away from the box.
Okay.
Yeah, so this
macam apa nama, kita kalau nak menggrowskan sesuatu tu, kita kena ada misi kan, visi and misi, barulah kita boleh berjaya, dan kita kena ada cita-cita yang tinggi lah. Dan apa pandangan doktor pula, ada yang mengatakan bahawa kalau sekiranya kita ingin berjaya, kita harus dikelilingi oleh orang-orang yang berjaya, kan. Mungkin kadang-kadang macam orang-orang muda sekarang ini, kawan-kawan mereka contohnya suka macam Nurul katakan tadi kan, masih muda lagi kan, masih nak berhibur dan sebagainya. Jadi pandangan doktor, orang kata nak berjaya kena kawan dengan orang yang berjaya macam doktor, ataupun dia nak berjaya tapi dia kawan dengan orang yang salah ke, atau pandangan doktor macam mana?
Make friends with everyone. Don't be biased. Don't because this is good, that is bad and everything. To me, every human is the same. Alright, whether they are high, they are low, doesn't mean that you need to mix with rich friend. You can also mix with some lesser, you know, lesser fortunate people as well. I think life is about finding a balance. Important thing is about finding balance. You mix with the good one, to bring you up faster, to grow, to make you grow even better and stronger. But you also mix with the less fortunate one so that you can also guide them at the same time. And also you feel blessed that of what you have currently and how you could actually, you know, synergize a formulation to make yourself even better, you know, so that you don't fall in that category of people, you see. So it is finding the balance basically. But of course, I very agree with you, is that networking is very important. We have to continue building friends, because nowadays in this current century, we cannot do ourselves. You know, we need a team, we need friends, we need support, we need the network, you see. Last time, those days, you know, like during my father or grandfather's era, we are talking about know-how. You must know how to do. But now it's not just about know-how, you need to know who as well. Yeah, if you don't know who, very hard. You have to, you know, the it's a very painful process. Yeah, so it's good to build your network around. That's why I personally is a very strong event believer, because how in 24 hours how many meetings can you meet, can? But if when you go events, you get to mingle around with more friends, you know, and stay in contact with them, you know, build rapport with them and see how we can synergize together and grow further. We have to hold each other's strength lah, you know, to go up basically.
So tarik dengan kata doktor, ya, iaitu rapport tu penting. Dalam sesama kena bekerja dalam satu kumpulan satu yang kuat. Okey, dahlah, inilah rahsia kejayaan, ya. Mungkin rahsia kejayaan Dr. Janson boleh menguruskan 4 kumpulan organisasi dengan 29 anak syarikat. Mungkin doktor boleh kongsikan rahsia-rahsia macam mana nak memastikan perniagaan tu kekal bertahan sehingga ke puncak. Maknanya dia mendaki-mendaki berada di puncak dan sustain dekat situ. Bagaimana?
I don't think I can do this alone. It's literally impossible to do this alone, having 29 subsidiaries. But I'm also very blessed that I have a very good management team, and I also got a very good employees, you know, that have been serving me. To me, I think in every business, human capital is very, very important. I think most of the businessmen, they tend to be over and gross about making money, making sales, but they forget about the employees. I think employees management is very, very important. We have to love everyone. We have to be in a family. We have to chart the vision together and fight towards the same objective together. I think that is the only way that we can steer a company, basically, because we are a group of companies now. We are no longer a one-man show. So, you know, there are a lot of times where even me myself, I don't think I am good at everything, mm-hmm. you know. So I allow my employees to share ideas, mm-hmm. you know, and bring insights of how to strive the business mm-hmm. better and how to make this even stronger basically.
Yeah. Kita cuba membayangkan Nurul bahawa yeah. seseorang yang dah pun berjaya menguruskan 4 kumpulan organisasi yeah. dan mempunyai 29 mm. anak syarikat di bawahnya, kita jangkakan bahawa mesti umurnya 50 tahun Betul. Ke atas kan, 40 Betul. Dan sebagainya, tapi ini baru 30 something.
35
dah beritahu dah apa
rahsia
kan, apa boleh berjaya sampai sekarang ini. Mm-hmm. Ya, tadi Nurul kata nak sustain dan sebagainya. Mm-hmm. Pernah tak doktor sendiri mengalami zaman kejatuhan mm-hmm. Dan juga bangkit semula ke, ataupun masuk-masuk je 17 tahun tu dah terus berjaya?
Naik terus berjaya, tak pernah jatuh.
Tak pernah jatuh.
Mungkin macam mana? Very good question. Mm-hmm. Actually, I'm not into a situation where I fall like deep down, mm-hmm. you know, but throughout the entire business journey, definitely there is always ups and downs, mm-hmm. you see. It's the stress level, you know, that we can manage, you mm-hmm. know, so far. So I'm very blessed in that, say. But having said, because I've also started gearing my family business as well, mm-hmm. because I'm one of the successors, mm-hmm. you see. Mm-hmm. So I've seen how my parents struggle, you mm-hmm. know, during the economic crisis, you mm-hmm. know, and things like that, and sometimes make wrong decision, mm-hmm. yeah, wrong decision making, you know. Invested in wrong agendas, you know, and things like that. So it's through sort of these processes, mm-hmm. you know, that makes us think better and wiser, basically. Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. In all business, you definitely have ups and downs. Uh-huh. It's just that we are very fortunate that we are not like down to the max, you know, that makes us harder to come back up again. Yeah. So we are quite okay in that aspect, basically.
But the important things, senyum saja.
Berhadapan dengan apa je masalah, senyum saja macam Dr. Janson.
Yeah,
dan apapun, kita akan berhenti rehat seketika dan kita akan kembali selepas ini.
Yeah.
Laporan pelbagai dimensi memaparkan isu semasa, lancongan, warisan dan budaya dari dalam dan luar negara. Saksikan jurnal Bernama di Bernama News Channel, semuanya tentang anda.
Kerjasama serumpun antara TV dan Bernama News Channel memaparkan isu semasa, budaya dan warisan Malaysia Indonesia. Saksikan Salam dari Jakarta.
Anda sedang merancang untuk bercuti, jalan-jalan bersama keluarga? Saksikan program 1001 Destinasi Malaysiaku untuk paparan percutian yang boleh membantu anda memilih destinasi bercuti bersama keluarga dan taulan. Setiap hari Khamis pada pukul 8.30 malam di Bernama News Channel. Semuanya tentang anda.
Menyambut Hari Kemerdekaan yang ke-61.
Saya nak ucapkan Hari Merdeka 31 Agustus. Tak tahu ni, tahu apa lama dah akan datang. Selamat Merdeka! Merdeka!
Kepada warga kerja Jabatan Imigresen Malaysia sebagai sebuah keluarga besar Jabatan Imigresen Malaysia, kepada rakyat negara kita, saya ucapkan selamat menyambut Hari Kebangsaan, selamat menyambut Hari Ulang Kemerdekaan Negara kita dengan menjadikan negara kita benar-benar harmoni, sejahtera, aman dan damai.
Selamat menyambut kemerdekaan yang ke-61. Saya juga berharap kemerdekaan tahun ini memberi lebih makna kepada rakyat Malaysia.
Selamat Hari Kemerdekaan yang ke-61. Saya berharap kemerdekaan kali ini lebih bermakna dengan kepimpinan kerajaan yang baru dan dapat membela khususnya warga Felda.
Merdeka! Merdeka! Merdeka!
Merdeka! Merdeka! Merdeka!
Masih lagi bersama dengan Dr. Janson Ang, merupakan Ketua Pegawai Eksekutif Janson Group, The Tang Giving Bank. Okey, kita nak sebenarnya tak habis lagi nak korek-korek rahsia dia ni. Sebenarnya banyak lagi nak tanya ni. Okey, jangan buang masa, kita tanya Dr. Janson sekarang. Okey, Dr. Janson, seperti kita tahu ya, doktor ni banyak mencubukan diri dalam bidang bisnes dan juga kerja-kerja NGO. Dalam masa sama, bagaimana nak balancekan kehidupan peribadi dengan kerjaya ni? Ada mungkin doktor boleh kongsi dengan penonton mengenai sisi peribadi doktor?
Kalau kita tengok ni macam tak ada masa ni. Kan? Kau tu dia, macam mana nak bagi masa tu?
Honestly, I don't really have time.
Yeah, betul tak? Kita tengok pun tahu.
And it has always been a complaint in my family, you know, in term of how. But yeah, I think Nurul, you're correct. I think we still always need to find balance, you know. I don't know how I find my balance, honestly. I really don't know. It's my life is just working and working and working, but I try to, of late, I try to, because I also just got a baby girl, I would also want to spend more time with my family members as well, so I try to reserve my time at least on the weekends not working. Yeah, if cannot achieve on Saturday, so at least Sunday, lah, you know, it must be a family time. But I always believe in a good balance, which I'm also still struggling in.
Kita kena percaya juga, Nurul, di sebalik kejayaan seseorang lelaki, ada isteri di belakangnya. Begitu juga macam doktor juga kan. Dan betul-betul kita kena balance juga kan. Dan kita juga harus mempunyai keluarga yang memahami kerjaya kita. Itu yang paling penting kan.
I think understanding how our life, you know, as a wife, they need to, you know, sort of compliment, you know, in that approach lah, you know, so long as you don't do anything naughty out there.
Betul-betul. Dan sekarang ni patutlah doktor tadi terdiam masa saya tanya. Rupanya masa tak boleh cukup. Mungkin lepas ni kita cuba bagi masa lebih banyak kepada keluarga, doktor. Okey, doktor. Dan kita nak bercakap mengenai The
Giving Bank.
Giving Bank. Kita tahu ya, The Giving Bank ni bukan satu nama yang asing lagi. Kalau kita datang di segmen-segmen, banyak segmen 11, banyak sponsor daripada The Giving Bank. Dan pada hari ni kita bawakan sendiri pengasas The Giving Bank, di 11, Dr. Janson Ang sendiri. Okey, Dr. Janson, bagaimana timbulnya idea untuk mewujudkan The Giving Bank?
I have always been into charity arena. Since young, when I first started making my first income, even from my part-time job, I've already been giving back to the society. Whether it's a lot, girl, sikit, girl, but the effort of giving is there. How I derive this is that basically, I think charity is already in our blood, in my family blood. Both my parents is also very big-hearted. They have been serving the community for, you name it, basically, they're in Lions Club, they're also in one of a very big foundation called Ciji from Taiwan, you know, and they are actually worldwide. So I've seen how they give back, you know, their time and effort in terms of volunteerism and finances to the community, and this is how they have groomed us, you know, to be up to this level basically. So what we do basically is, why I come up with the Giving Bank is because also to address a few red tapes, because I find that a lot of the NGOs around Malaysia is actually struggling. And I also see a few points where there is no transparency in terms of charity, and people start taking charity as scams, you know, and things like that. So I think it's almost time for us to do something about it, you know, to get the community know that there are a legit and a transparent organisation out there. So what I did for the Giving Bank is basically we are an online crowdfunding platform. We allow donors to come in and contribute, you know, whenever or wherever they want. Basically, it's an online crowdfunding, and we do not limit in terms of how much they need to give, you know, and things like that. This is to address the issue of charity is not only for the rich and for the powerful, but it's also for any one of us who wants to do good, you know. So if today, for example, I wake up from the bed and I feel like doing good, you know, this morning I can just go into the Giving Bank and donate maybe probably 10 ringgit or something like that, which everyone can afford, you see. So I'm trying to bring good values back into community, those that can give, and also to help those people that would really needed help. So basically, and to address the transparency component is that basically what we do is we respect all our donors. Why the current, I would say most of the NGOs, they are always very aggressive in finding funds. But I think they forgot the second part is to maintain as well. And how to maintain is the only way to do that is to create more trust between the donors as well. And transparency is very important, and this is what we instill most in the giving bank. So assuming today, Nurul, you actually donated 10 ringgit to us, you will know exactly how we use the 10 ringgit, because we will send you a report. Let's say we have purchased this cruci rodder for this pachi, you know, that needed so much in time that he needed so much. So we use your 10 ringgit as part of the contribution to the wheelchair. You will receive a full report. So you know exactly, oh, my 10 ringgit has been, you know, spent on good use for good cause to this uncle, you know, to get his wheelchair, you see, because he cannot walk and things like that. So this is how we address transparency and honesty. So I'm also again very blessed that all my donors actually come with us, stay with us and continue with us basically.
Kalau tengok The Giving Bank ni sebenarnya banyak aktiviti-aktiviti yang telah pun dijalankan dan saya percaya bahawa kalau nak wujudkan The Giving Bank ni sebenarnya bukannya sesuatu yang mudah.
Betul.
Kan? Dan adakah dapat bantuan-bantuan mungkin daripada syarikat-syarikat NGO yang lain ataupun The Giving Bank ini sendiri diwujudkan sendiri atas Dr. Janson sendiri?
We build ourselves, we sustain ourselves. we so far we are not out there getting funds from, because my corporate also has this policy that in terms of my business, whatever that we profit, you know, 30% of our profit margin goes into the giving bank to help people. And on another aspect is we also have those like crowdfunding, kan? We have people coming in and give us the smaller amount, like 10, 100, 200, you know, that sort of thing. So we can sustain ourselves basically, and this is how we use, we have to manage the fund internally lah, you see, to see how we can actually in fact we are the one going out to help other NGOs. So some of the NGOs, you know, like even like old folks home or orphanage, they needed stock supplies, they need to pay their rent or their electrical bills, you know, so we'll try to apportion something for them.
Dan setakat ni The Giving Bank mensasarkan jenis bantuan bagaimana, adakah di dalam Malaysia sahaja ketika ini ataupun turut memberi bantuan di luar negara?
Currently we are only in Malaysia. We are not very old yet. We just established this not too long ago. It's about one year 7 months.
Baru lagi.
So we are still an infant, you know, baby. But surprisingly, we are doing pretty well. Over these 1 year, 6 months, we have completed 49 projects. And out of the 49 projects, we have rather said help or assisted 4,800 old people.
Walaupun usianya lihat baru, tetapi dia tak nampak macam baru.
Gempak juga. The way we move is quite fast and aggressive because we want the market to accept us.
Baik.
You see?
Okay, Doktor, kalau kita tengok sekarang ini di kaca televisyen sekarang ini, ini merupakan program di mana ini dan apa antara aktiviti-aktiviti yang dibuat di sini sebenarnya, Doktor?
This one is one of our project where we bring 4 orphan homes out to IOI, IOI Mall in Putrajaya. We brought them, we make them happy, we let them have some recreasi, so they can actually play and at the same time learn. So we focus a lot in education as well. So these are all the orphans. Some of them are from HIV homes, you know, and some of them, they are being abused. So they are very afraid of confronting humans basically, you know, because they are being abused by their parents, you know, and things like that. So we bring them out, we tell them that love is all around the corner, you know, there are a lot of good people around. But of course we have sponsors coming in as well, corporate sectors coming in, you know. We also give out products and monetary values to these homes as well.
Okey, doktor, nak tahu juga ya. Sebelum ni dia lebih kepada bantuan-bantuan kepada anak-anak yatim, golongan yang memerlukan. Dan mungkinkah The Giving Bank turut memberi bantuan kepada mangsa banjir ataupun bagaimana?
Yes, we do. We do. In fact, we were one of the first to actually move out to Penang. I think if you remember one of the very bad incident in Penang during the flood. I think we have sent up about 13 full loaded lorry to Penang in terms of supplies. So we have all the cleaning materials, tilam, you know, detergents and everything. And we activated our volunteering system as well. So we have volunteers in all regions basically to see who has the ability and the availability to actually go and support as well. So we also come in terms of volunteerism, not only just in terms of finance but also in volunteerism.
Okay, doktor, nak tahu juga sekiranya mereka di luar sana menonton rancangan 9/11 ketika ini dan ingin memberikan sumbangan kepada The Giving Bank, di manakah saluran yang perlu mereka lakukan?
Just go into our website. It's called www.thegivingbank.com. Everything is there. You will see the donation page, and that's where you make your pledge, basically. You will be getting an official receipt on the spot. It's like Grab, kan? The moment you get down, you get your receipt. So everything is automated now. So we are using technology to revolve around charity element as well.
Dan yang bagusnya, kalau misalnya kata kita memberikan bantuan kepada The Giving Bank ini sebenarnya, kita tahu, contohnya, kita bagi RM10, RM10 kita itu disalurkan ke mana dan buat apa, kan? Macam doktor kata-kata tadi, mungkin
ketelusan.
Ketelusan beli kursi roda dan sebagainya, kan? Jadi memang tiada ini apa amount, kan? Terserah kepada mereka nak derma ke ada certain amount serendah RM10 ke atau bagaimana?
No.
Terpulang, kan?
Ya, terpulang.
Terpulang kepada anda semua, kan? Saya di kesempatan ini saya nak tanya jugalah kepada doktor, kan? Kita tahu bahawa doktor dah pun berjaya sekarang ini, kan? Kita tengok dah memang begitu sukses sekali. Ada tak perancangan-perancangan yang mungkin belum lagi digapai? Ada lagi yang macam aku belum dapat lagi achievement ni? Mungkin ada tak? Belum lagi digapai lah sehingga umur sekarang ini.
Perancangan doktor.
I think enough so far. Whatever I have read so far, I think it's good enough. The only thing now I'm focusing a lot is due to my latest baby lah. The Giving Bank is my latest baby. I want to see it soar, you know, to a higher level, and I want Malaysia to stand out. Because I'm also quite saddened for the fact that there is no one solid organization, a charity foundation in Malaysia that is actually internationally recognized. Talk about Lions Club, it's not from Malaysia. Rotary Club is not from Malaysia. World Vision is not from Malaysia. UNICEF is not. Red Cross, St. John, you name it. Nothing from Malaysia. So if the Giving Bank can continue, prosper and do good, I believe one day we should be able to be internationally known as well.
Itu dia penerangan yang cukup mendalam. Tarik nafas, saya hembus sebab saya rasa sangat berbesar hati dengan perkongsian daripada Dr. Janson, seorang usahawan yang berjaya dan memiliki hati yang begitu besar sekali untuk membantu rakyat Malaysia yang memerlukan menerusi The Giving Bank. Dan semoga usaha beliau akan berterusan, akan mendapat maklum balas yang sangat positif daripada masyarakat di luar sana. Dan sekali lagi kepada anda yang ingin menghulurkan bantuan, boleh ke website iaitu www.thegivingbank.com. Dan apa pun ribuan terima kasih diucapkan kepada Dr. Janson kerana sudi meluangkan masa bersama kita pada hari ini di Night Level.
Betul. Kalau nak dapatkan apa-apa saja tips, mungkin anda boleh pergi saja ke Facebook doktor sendiri, iaitu cari saja Dr. Janson Ang di sana.
Janson Ang.
Dr. Janson Ang di sana. Mungkin boleh berkenalan. Tapi berkenalan bukannya nak apa-apa. Nak memberikan anda inspirasi untuk berjaya. Okey, kita nak berasa ketika untuk memberi laluan kepada Buletin Bernama.
Kembali selepas ini.